Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm doing exposition of John 16, verse 1 to 4. Now, in the previous one, you know, Christ Jesus told his laborers, he had no disciple. The word disciple is from discipline. You discipline natural men, not the spiritual twice born people. So Jesus had laborers working in the vineyard. To enter that vineyard, you have to pass through the narrow gate. Remember the covenant of narrow and wide gate. These Pope and other people, they have wide gate, old system. Our is a new covenant of narrow gate for the solitary. Not two people can pass. Solitary mean this is the temple of God and you have to give your own account to God. Nobody can give your account. So these dog-collared people and anybody who stands between man and God, he is Antichrist. And tell him on his face, nobody can stand because the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart from top, the temple high priest, to bottom, mean the village rabbi, all out of the way. Direct approach through his word. We don't communicate with our Father through prayer. Prayer was used to communicate with Yahweh, which the rabbi kept the people alienated, because Yahweh is not inside us, he is outside somewhere. This is the temple of God, and inside us is the God himself. So we are no more alienated from our Father. So we don't say prayer, because he knows our heart before we say anything from our mouth. Jesus never said a prayer. He always thanked our Father. So we can also thank him when we receive his word. So we communicate with our Father with his word, not with blah, 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 Father in heaven and all that. Our Father is here inside. So I have said all these things to you to keep you from falling away. They will put you out of the synagogues, because in the synagogue, the rabbi is worshipping Yahweh, and Yahweh is demiurge God. He is not real. So he does not know the real Father, because he is the ruler of natural men. He has disciples. We don't have disciples enough. We have fellowships of brethren. So that's what it is, you know, the rabbi thought of God somewhere in heaven, alienated, but they did not know that this is the real temple of God. And if real temple, then Father is inside you. Whereas the Samaritan village rabbis, they knew the all this, they knew the Father, you know, our Father, which is this is the temple of God. And they, village rabbi, they taught the scripture to their disciples very good. As the Samaritan woman is a proof that how she vetted Jesus in spirit. Where from she learnt? She learnt it from the village rabbi. So whose are better than the Samaritans? Remember when Jesus was telling these Jewish people in the temple, your fathers are devil. But when they said your fathers are devil, not many people understood, you know, why he calling them devil. Or not even today people are understanding them. Why the Jewish were they're called their fathers are devils? Because they had broken their covenant with Abraham. Abraham was not a Jew. He was a Semitic race. So when you build your covenant with Abraham in tribe, tribal link. Tribe is outside, inside is Jew. So when you are a Jew inwardly and not outwardly, then you are good. But when you become a Jew outwardly, then what will you be inwardly? Nothing. Fake. Fake Jews of shawl and every dress, you know. So when you become Jew outwardly, you break your covenant with Abraham. When you break covenant with Abraham, you become son of a devil, son of the Satan of the Most High, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. When you go to Hajj, and that one, the first day you stone 7 stones at this Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. So, the Egyptian had a strong sense of worshipping Adam, whereas the Jewish people, they hated Adam, they hated Abraham, and hated Yahweh. They were giving lip service to Yahweh and saying to them, we have Abraham as our father. John the Baptist said, don't you say that you have Abraham as your father? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. Stones mean thick-headed people. You think clever people, that these simpletons who are from villages, because they haven't read Torah or anything, you know. You think, you know, they are stupid, you know, they're stones. I can turn them into the sons of Abraham. So John the Baptist, when he baptized only the chosen people in the name of Abraham, not in the name of this Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This is all corruption. And these people are with the dog collar. They are working for money and not for God. So they will put you out of the synagogues. That means even I, you know, went to attend a lecture somebody in Oxford in Wycliffe Hall. Now over there in Oxford, they don't get many people to attend the lectures. So what they say, when they advertise a lecture, they say there will be refreshment after the lecture. Then people turn up. That so they are desperate for audience. And somebody came from Middle East, Jerusalem, on New Testament to give a lecture, seminar. So I went there to attend it. I had booked it, you know, I had written to them. But when I turned at the door, and they said, oh, have you booked it? I forgot, you know, whether I booked it or not. I said, I don't remember, you know, I might have booked it. He said, no, it's only invited people who can come. And was turned out. I was not allowed to attend the lecture. And that is Oxford University. They are super donkeys carrying holy books. So they don't know our Father. They know only book knowledge. Ask them, why John the Baptist did not baptize a woman or a Gentile? They have no idea. So they don't know our Father. They don't know Father in flesh. How can they know Father in spirit? They don't know whose son was Jesus. How can they know whose son was Christ? Whose son is Christ? Because Christ is in the beginning and is forever. Jesus was born and he died. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering service to God. And they will do these things because they have not known the Father, nor me.
Which airline is that?
But I have said these things to you,
you have to do it
that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told them to you. So Jesus told us, warned us, that you people will not know God. Thomas went to India and they beheaded him. thinking they are doing service to God, those Brahman, you know, in India, they beheaded him, that they are doing service to our father. But Brahman, they were blind, spiritually blind. They did not know God. But they thought by offering his service, sacrifice, they are pleasing their gods. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. Jesus was with you, with us physically, you know, now he is spiritually with us through his word. So a man, you know, lives on even if he dies because what he has said or what he has written, if we remember, if we understand him, then we are speaking to that man. So when we understand gospel, we are speaking to our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus is not a Lord or not a God. He is our brother. If you call him Lord, then lords have slaves. So he hasn't come to set us free then. If you call him God, then you make him equal to Father. Jesus clearly said, you know, Son is Son, Father is Father. So you can't replace Father with Son. So in Jesus, if we say we have one Father and we are all brethren, and Jesus being possessing with the Spirit with capital S, he is our anointed elder brother. So he is above us. We have Spirit with small s. This Spirit with small s is the Spirit of man. Spirit of man is common sense. We call the people simpletons because they don't have common sense. Children don't have common sense. So that's why we forgive them, you know, if they make mistake. But adult, we have those who have common sense, they need to be given their sentence. So with this thing, you know, I hope you will understand. And let's preach gospel is as simple as ABC. Do you think I'm preaching this one from a book? Can you find what I say in a book? That John the Baptist never baptized a woman or a Gentile, and he baptized in the name of Abraham. It all comes through revelations, but it's all written in the Bible. You have to dig it out using Holy Spirit, common sense. If you have Holy Spirit, you can preach gospel as I am doing now. I'm using Holy Spirit and not any book or any professor and anything. These professors you have in universities, they don't know who created Adam and Eve, never mind God. So they are super donkeys carrying holy books. So it's all up to you. Our Father God blesses you.